There we go. Hello. I'm playing some DvZ today, and we're on the mighty Hergesnerv,
Mighty
cat god of the north.
Hergesnerv.
Is she of the north? I don't know. I kind of assume she is.
No,
Well.
she's the dwarven, just the dwarven cat god, who, due to dwarven arrogance, was the only god willing and/or able theologically to answer the dwarves' call in their time of need. Whether or not she could truly defeat the
Sure.
evil that she was called to defeat is, called into question in the legend, and has been theologically debated by dwarven scholars for generations. The only thing that is clear is that it was not completely defeated, and that Hergesnerv is currently napping, as cat gods are wont to do.
So, as you might have been able to tell from that, this is one of Teb's maps.
Yeah.
What gave it away? Does it sound like the fact it was written by somebody who drank too much whiskey after a lonely, lonely night of loneliness all alone?
Honey whiskey, too.
That's it, yeah, that's it.
Sounds about right.
Yep.
So,
Oh
we're gonna
gosh,
try dwarving on this game.
how much gold did we put into this map? I can't remember, but I don't think we anticipated this much.
Not insane amounts.
It's
Does
gonna
it?
be interesting because, well, again, we have the map builder here.
As always,
And
can we?
Teb's classic style is to do maps unlike maps that any other person would do.
I figured that any audience could churn out a map just, hey guys, we have like a front wall in a valley, and then we have like a second shrine just outside a fortress, and then we go into the fortress. Like any old idiot could churn out five of those maps in a given week. Six if they were Fallen Alba.
Oh, okay, how are we gonna do rip each other's maps part two?
Oh no, that comes later. That comes okay.
However, the thing about this
That's
one
not a
is
fair
it
co that's not
started as a serious map, because you built
I
some really nice
well
terrain and then went,
this Alba,
and
have you got do you have an
built like the
establishing shot of
weirdest
the
thing.
mountain yet?
No, but hold on,
So
I'm getting stuff.
Man, they got a trebuchet!
They don't know how to use it though. They would have blown us up by
What's a
now.
trebuchet?
Aw, Lance! Lance of history. I love that trebuchet. Reap and I built that trebuchet.
I would like to point out that trebuchet, if you do get a close look at it, you'll note that the counterweight for that trebuchet to fire would swing back into the central column of the trebuchet. Absolutely. Absolutely breaking the trebuchet after the first shot. And the fact is, there are some boulders. There are boulders on this map, which we've included, where, like, you can see where a boulder had gone through the wall. Meaning this trebuchet has already fired at least four times in its life without destroying itself.
Magical trebuchet.
Yeah, it's the magic of.
Oh,
I don't
hey, the
know.
chimneys are having some fun with the
The
trebuchet.
magic of the warp
Roleplay.
cores.
Which is. Anyway, so the way this
Christ is
map kind of
connected.
happened was,
Go.
Christ
I had an
connected.
idea. I had an idea for the map. It was sort of Olympus. You have giant mountain temple at the top.
Yeah, let's go get a
So
quick look at
that's how that kind of
that.
started. Then things got a little bit crazy because
Yeah.
I built the
There's the
mountain.
trebuchet.
I built the mountain and then I looked at the mountain and I thought,
It's too hard. I don't know what to do.
I'm lazy and I don't understand world edit.
Goodness, the thing is not thingying.
Anyway, so I call these guys onto the server and I'm like, hey guys, got a sweet mountain. Can't be bothered to finish the map. This is after we've done belly and I was in a map building mood now. Like, can't be bothered to finish the map. Go nuts. Let's just. And then I logged out.
Christ is
And then
connected.
Well, you did.
You built the
Christ
arch.
connected.
I built the
Mark.
arch. Yeah, I started building that's like a temporary arch, but I built it in
Wow,
like
that don't help me at
I
all.
built it with
Okay.
emerald and pink glass because I did like a brief YouTube internet search like what contrasts green and green red? Oh, that goes really great with pink. And I thought
Is that why that happened?
pretty much based on the internet search. Anyway, so that happened, and I built this archway, and then I
I
kind
don't
of
have any
logged.
torches, for
And then I just kind of logged out and wait, and you know, a couple of days later came back in, and this, and some idiot had put cat ears on it.
Some what?
Some idiot. Some Finnish fool had put cat ears on it. And I will never get tired of telling this story just because of how fun this map was. And so I think I'd hung the central banner. I hung the banners from it, and they'd also put the whiskers on it, on the banners.
But wasn't there? That wasn't all, because there was a bottle of milk and a saucer.
Yeah, there was a bottle of milk which Price has like connected. Milk for the milk
oh,
god.
Dear.
No milk. It had milk.
Just connecting and disconnecting, and it's making a noise.
It had milk for the cornflakes.
Yeah,
Chris.
It was something like, blah blah blah, milk for the cornflake, which is a Warhammer reference. Anyway, and so I'm
you added that.
I don't think I think it was Sub actually who added that.
Okay. I just put in milk for the milk god.
Yeah. So anyway, so. Oh gosh, I'm assassinated.
Oh no, I'm frozen. Something's wrong with me.
Are you being assassinated right now?
No, I'm not. But my... Oh,
Fall
was assassinated. That was weird.
So,
oh, no, you weren't. Okay, never mind. I thought somebody had...
In any case, so what you ended up with is... Like, we had the cat thing, and I thought, you know what, I'm going to roll with this. And like, the rest of the map clicked into place, like, ridiculously quickly after that. And then me and... I think this one was we, actually. I think it's mostly... Wait, I think, because this is the one you got Jimmy, Super Jimmy built up. I think you were the one who did this.
Do what?
Built this map.
Oh, yeah. Oh, is it the one I didn't really do much, did I? Sipa was here. He did that too.
What I like is how many people
I
were
don't
involved
feel like
in
I
this
did much.
And how everyone denied it.
I don't remember what I actually did. Seriously.
I made a monster banner.
Yes. Yeah. So Paul made the monster banner. Skipper made the cat ears. I made the mountain.
I went around attaching buttons to everything.
Even cat ears were actually heavily influenced by Millicent Oak.
Yeah.
I'm sure Tom did something we can blame him for as well at some point, but Alda helped to build the temple at the top.
Try and these beautiful stairs that I'm about to just
the stairs from second to third. So anyway, so all that happened, and all of these things happened, all kind of not at once, but all slowly but surely over the
water.
I love this gravel which is protected here.
I know. I mean, blame this event, right? It's like, you get to here, and it's like, no, this particular blob of gravel is protected.
It's probably under the shrine, yeah.
I don't have any mortar. Does anyone have mortar? I'm going up to the final, right?
You're all the way up there? I'm not going that well. I'm not going.
I'm going to build defenses, like a gym.
So once the map theme came together, The map just followed it, you know? Just, like, we had a theme, worked out what the theme was, and then suddenly the map got built, and that was really, really good. But
are you really telling me I can't destroy this stupid banner? Oh, there we go. Fine.
So, first to second shrine, we actually always thought that the mobs would spawn traditionally, and then I specified, you know, third to final, they spawn in that thing. It's way up above. I actually think that were it not for the cattier stuff, I would have been sitting on that idea and probably used it in another map eventually. But I wanted to get the map. I wanted to get the idea, and so we did. That the mobs spawn above the final shrine, which I think was partly because I thought that would be really, really cool. No one had done it yet. No one has done it since.
This staircase is all Teb's fault. We had nothing to do with this.
Which one's that?
The one that's just green and quartz and cobblestone and pink.
God, yes. The one from second to third. Look, my thought was that the dwarves would very quickly work out how the map worked and just use that to run really quickly up the stairs. These stairs were that colour to encourage them to get up the stairs so they didn't have to put up with the stairs anymore.
Possible.
Yeah, exactly. Built. So, you know, so the map's built, and, you know, we've got that there. And we put it, and let's see, were there any other ideas we worked into this? I think we had the nice banners, we had the temple at the top made of quartz, which at the time was meant to just explode and melt in the presence of anything, you know, stronger than a light breeze. Turns out they've since fixed the explosive resistance of it. Problem is, the problem with this map is you obviously have the battering ram, which had the flame marks behind it, which was something that I think repadded. And problem is, the dwarves overbuild walls on this map. If you just sat back with this front wall here, it would be a lot better. Unfortunately, dwarves...
That's the case on all the maps.
Yeah. As it stands, they built right up to the monster mob spawn, and the one impact skeleton behind it is going to get people killed really, really fast by spawn.
And that's good, because that's not how natural segregation works.
Anyway.
I have 800 man already.
No, that's not the word I wanted to use.
Did you say, what, natural segregation?
Yeah, I
don't know. Dang, Paul!
That's not the word I wanted to use. Never
mind. That's racist.
That's racist, okay.
Anyway. So, the map all eventually rolled together into its current form.
I mean, it is loopy.
Oh, it's a bit mad. It was never made to be. It was not meant to be a traditional map, and in that we succeeded. Because, as I said before, anyone can churn out a traditional style map. You see dozens of them on the subreddits. You know, you see like his, and don't get me wrong, they're all very lovely maps, but we've seen them before. They're going to play very similarly.
Dwarves are stupid.
Which is why maps like Rift and like Astral Isles and like, are there any other maps? I mean, Character in theory, but then there's all maps made by me in Doom, which probably says something about the way these maps are made.
Arcanzium,
maybe? But maps...
I remember Arcanzium.
But maps which are just slightly differently built and slightly differently put together... You know, like, you need these maps in rotation because they're different, and they stop the game becoming boring. Also, Plains and Belly of the Beast to a degree, but Belly of the Beast is, again, an outdoor shrine, an entrance to a keep, and a keep, which is a whale.
Well, to be fair, that map has water surrounding the keep, and you're probably dead if you're out there.
Oh yeah, it's lovely, isn't it?
Void, a void...
I mean, like, don't get me wrong, like, I don't like Void. I think Void is a poor mechanic, and a cheap mechanic.
Oh, in the new map I'm going to make eventually when I feel like I'm over people hating my maps.
No one hates your maps, Paul.
There's going to be Void in it as a feature, but it's going to be treated a little bit differently from the usual
Void.
So Void.
You think that that's going to help with people hating your maps?
No, that's the opposite, and I hope that, you know. You think those maps were bad and dangerous and you died on them really easily? Well... I'm going to show you.
Anyway, so we put Hergesnerv up on the subreddit, and somebody immediately pointed out and went, circle jerk. Which it isn't.
Because well, it was silly.
Because if you take away the cat ears and the whiskers...
Circle jerk is something like an in-joke. This is not an in-joke.
This is just silly.
This
is just slightly silly.
There's no memes here. There's
You take away the cat ears and you take away the battering ram with fire coming out the back, and what you have is actually a map.
A map that's pretty weird.
Like, if you take Rainbow Land, for example, falls under a similar category. You take Rainbow Land and you take away the Nyan cat spawn and you take away the rainbows. Yeah, you have something resembling a map underneath it.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's just how...
This is a map. Rainbow Land just resembles a map. That's nice.
Well, there is a map underneath. It's just how thick the layer of makeup is. And in Hergesnerv's case, it's like a horse mark. In Rainbow Land's case, it's like...
Man,
you took,
I wish I had blue glue. I'm trying put proper defenses up at final, and I don't even have regular glue, let alone blue.
I'm really glad we made this map on island. Because I need to go around the dwarves.
I don't know what he's up to.
Because nobody ever dares to defend the left and right of the monster spawn, because there's Void there, and it's blown up to the Void. So I mean, just go through it.
I mean, we actually made this map, quick confession about this map. This map was actually, because I didn't know how maps worked, this map was actually a super.
Am I the only one working on the last shrine, says some guy, who I can't even see him. Nope, that's some other guy.
So yeah, he's probably building a proc hole in the toothpaste.
Yeah. Tunnel.
This map was actually built on just a regular super flat world, and then I, you know, slash replaced and all the dirt into bedrock a bit later than I really should have done. So there may actually be a void hole somewhere in this map if you look hard enough.
Fun times.
But in any case, what you end up with, but yeah, but then we just deleted all the chunks around the edge of those
voids. Oh, there's alders. God damn it.
But, like, we put this map on the subreddit, and Nis found it amusing enough to test.
I remember, I've recorded that first test. The first test crashed when the second shrine was about to fall.
Which I think I know, I mean, I have a theory as to why that was. Which is that Nis tried to force second shrine fall, and because I'd said, like, in the post, Matt, because when second shrine falls, you know, if the chains holding up the thing could explode, that would be, you know, super mega awesome. So I suspect he may have tried to do that, and that level of exploding
just
may
too
have...
awesome for the server.
Yeah.
There's still a sign for mod spawn over here.
Again, this
ghost
is
something... never gets removed.
Yeah, this never removes signs, which I find hilarious personally.
Somebody's gonna put this, remove the sign.
Apparently, that guy
else,
was
and somebody's gonna find it.
Doing the thing with the thing instead.
And the what?
Yeah, he was building a proc hall for the thing, which is.
See, and that always and this has always amused me about this map. Whenever I see a video of this map, this is gonna be the only video where this isn't the case. But the second shrine falls, and someone somewhere thinks, oh no, we have the proc hole, it's so narrow, it's the only way up, this is really unfair to the mobs, and they sit there and they wait for upwards of 2 to 3 minutes. Just going, wonder where the mobs are.
And then the shrine's falling.
And then the shrine starts falling.
I'm making all these defenses of cobble. Could use some mortar.
I'm not exactly doing anything toward. Hang on, I'll run up. I've never actually played the dwarf on this map. But.
Yeah, me neither. Unless, that was this one test that crashed. That was the one I played on this dwarf.
We've got all these lovely banners around here, which no longer mean anything to anyone. Yep, someone's made some lovely proc holes here. They've blocked off all the light, actually, while doing so, which is going to really, really be hilarious in future.
Broke all your stairs.
Thank you,
apparently Skype has commands?
Yeah, it does. That's why it cannot paste commands easily.
Oh, gosh. Oh, my gosh. These stairs, to point out, I built these stairs by hand.
I just used an ogre as a means of transportation. I saw him run at me, I aligned myself, and he punched me directly into the shrine.
Nice.
Alba?
Remember the creepers?
Hi.
The creeper spam on Matt Walker and stuff had that
come
video.
Come back this way? Oh.
Where he just got blown into the shrine base.
Do you have any cobble?
Yeah, sure. while I'm at it, have that,
I have other things.
But these stairs, man, they are ugly. And I built this entirely by hand, so the pattern is probably wrong. Because we all know I'm the master of symmetry.
Oh, I love this so much.
Oh, come in here, Jimmy.
What are you doing, Lee?
Goodbye.
Nobody's covering the flanks.
Nope.
From the mob spawn.
Nope,
they're... Why
do you need to cover the flanks when you build right up to the mob's faces?
Because I'm going all the way around the dwarves into the forest, into the tunnel.
That tunnel. Jimmy. Nobody ever goes near that tunnel. It's amazing.
Yep. Isn't so safe.
Making... There's me and another guy now up on top of the Arch of Hergesnerv. That front wall has been destroyed. Really quite nicely.
Why is Jimmy making holes?
Gosh darn it. My...
Was that you?
Yeah, that was me.
I just killed you. And then you said hi,
I
like
covers that
side, late.
So I blew up that wall and went over.
I really do... I like how the map looks, though.
You're just
like,
gonna
from,
walk in there.
Like, from the arch... From Hergesnerv's arch, you look down... Someone is shooting at me, that's very rude, guy. But you look down, and you can see, in the distance, the mob camp, the trebuchet, a battered tent. You can see, like, the wall of, the palisade wall, the dirt wall the mobs have dug to protect their encampment. And then all these other walls. Has anyone used the tunnel that comes up underneath the wall? Because there's a sapper tunnel behind one of those. There's a couple of little arrow guards, and they have tunnels under them.
I've not seen anybody. I don't even know where that tunnel comes out.
It comes out under the front courtyard. And nobody... The first test game we played on it, it was quick. All the dwarves ran out to inspect things, and you just saw one of them, like, look underneath and go, that's a tunnel. And then you just see this moment where they just put the tunnel back under the ground, and they, like, dug up at the other side and just went...
On our side, it's locked up, so we're blowing it up now.
Yeah.
Well, I'm blowing it up. There we go. Oh no, it's completely filled.
Oh.
Hold on, I'm a gobo, I can just break all this.
Like, in a perfect world, I would have had Nis program it, or Nis would somehow program it such that it creates the tunnels, like, just as the game starts. By just, like, doing something Nisavini.
Paste the thing in.
Yeah. Nisavin, do the thing!
Oh wow!
Do the Nisavin.
I also like the fact that the gate has been covered in everything gets covered in stone.
Oh no, Alder has rain.
Yeah, I really do.
Oh, that really loud rain.
I thought you were crumpling tin foil.
My goodness, I can't hear the game.
This thing is filled with gravel. What the heck?
I don't know why did I expect you to say filled with walls.
Now, is your roof made of tinfoil?
Wow, okay, that's... Oh. Oh, they blocked it up.
Yeah.
Hey boys, I'm here!
I'm just really happy with how this map came out.
So I'm just going to mute. You're going to have to be entertaining until the rain stops being quite so much noise.
My frame rate is so bad. Okay. I need to be Ogre Magi. Oh, yes!
Well,
yes.
That's going to be entertaining enough. You don't need people speaking.
So, the thing which Alda can agree with and will in no way dispute right now is the fact that, to be honest, she had the least influence on this map and did nothing towards the temple.
Lies! All lies!
she disputes it. She said you would say silent. Stay silent.
Move out of my way, you idiots. Oh my god.
Yeah, this map actually really turned out quite okay.
It wouldn't be the same without the monster banner, though.
It would not.
Paul is the only one who is actually proud of anything he done towards that.
I came out in credit. We all came out. We came out in credit for this map. I did, at least. I didn't have too far. Look, after Belly of the Beast, there was only so much more down I could accomplish.
Mm-hmm.
I really wish that there's like a document. If there's a DvZ documentary, like, no, about our map building, we like from the team that brought you Caladianum, Asylum, Mount Willikers 2.0, and Hergesnerv. I mean, even the name came from a bit of silliness from Sub.
Mill.
Was it Mill? I thought it was
Mill.
I get them confused.
Oh, I got blocked off.
You're like, ah!
I got blocked off into the tunnel.
But yeah, but like, because Mill made a post on the DvZ subreddit, just like, I'm so sick of all these boring names. Why not name it something like da 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 or the Eyebrow of Hergesnerv or something? And I thought, you know what, we're gonna use that name because why not?
I am really almost out of cobble.
That's a rat. Bad rat. No gold speedy.
Kick in.
Not that there's much gold to steal.
Okay. Right.
I just attacked an obsidian block.
Good lord! Those obsidian blocks are dangerous, man. You've got to make sure to keep them in line. But so yeah, so everything about this map just kind of happened, I think, is the way that it just... Like, this is the map that never should have happened, but did. What was the Doomwave, actually? Is it Gobo?
Gobo Squad.
It was eight creepers.
If it would be more effective if not zombie. Everybody had some fall damage reduction. Or else everybody would, like, just die.
But yeah, so this entire map is kind of stupid, but it was a fun kind of stupid. Plus, like, once we worked out what we were building with it, like, once the cat ears went up, everyone just enjoyed themselves with this. I think that's the real... I think that's what made this map the best thing ever. The friendship. And the mockery.
Indeed.
But mostly the mockery.
I tried my hardest to sabotage it, but... backfired.
That was a clear sign that Hergesnerv had blessed this map.
You can sabotage it by giving me that command and maybe, like, turn half the core into cobble. No, bedrock. And half the trees into bedrock.
There are some foibles of this map that we haven't talked about too much. Like the bedrock trees. The problems with the quarry. Those are Nissevin's problems, man. He can set his protection set better.
Oh, you dear. Infiltrator.
Oh my god, Doom is building a roof.
What's with the obsidian blocks?
All the time I've spent this stuff? No way, guys.
Which obsidian blocks? The ones near Rob spawn.
Might be the monster banner. Pedestals. Pedestals.
Pedestrians. That's not good news.
Oh, there's lag.
One of my arrows hit something. Give me a proc.
Oh my goodness! I cannot hit this stupid scale up to save my actual life. Oh, there we go. That wasn't even me, that was the other guy.
Did you just say you can't hit this skeleton to save your African children, or did I just...
What the heck?
To save my actual life.
Okay, that makes sense.
My god.
How do we save...
My goodness.
So, Elder Dash, tell us about your African children.
Let's not go into this.
Oh, which means the charity you set up.
Oh.
So in any case, this is the same list that spawned this map. So maybe we're just insane.
Absol, can't argue with that.
But
I've seen pretty much nothing of the action.
Of all the maps we've built. This has got to be, in some way, in your heart of hearts, you know this is your favourite.
No, that's Paladier number.
Really?
Yeah.
No, sorry to...
In your heart of hearts, you know it's Hergesnerv.
Well, I don't build maps, so...
It's the part of your mind that talks to you late at night after a few tequilas and goes, hey, you did a great thing with Hergesnerv.
No way, I do like Hergesnerv.
Yeah, that's why I don't drink tap.
I thought you were going to say
Thomas?
Do like tequila.
Thomas Lowe.
Yes.
Oh no, he's not in the channel. Never mind. I thought you said he's
looking rough.
Jimmy, no roof. Oh, roof. Plus, it doesn't matter. Plus, it doesn't matter anyway. They're going to start spawning on top of the arch. And then
Oh, I have no cobble. Do you have any cobble? Anyone?
I have like two stacks.
But that's like a fraction of that would help me out. Hi, Fall. Hi, behind you.
Armor gone, Fall. I know. Hi. Oh. You have a mason hat.
Do I? Oh, look.
I have a helmet.
You want my cobble? Okay, well, there
Thank
you go.
You. Thank you.
I can 1v1 wolves wet better than can like 7v1 wolves. So everybody's getting in the way.
See, this particular phase of the map is the bit I kind of enjoy the most. This is the pure madness phase. But no one is.
I don't think anyone would deny that.
Oh no.
Well, this map.
I felt like an idiot.
That's the kind of danger I'm talking to the dwarves about. Because now we've got gobo boxes just. Gobos everywhere, zombies everywhere, everything everywhere, panic in the streets.
There's no streets on this map.
Exactly. But with our children at our feet, we're on the worst book gone.
There's. Oh!
Wolves! Well, a wolf.
So basically, this map is also a counterpoint to anybody on the Reddit who said, has anyone ever tried a vertical style map, as in where it goes up and down as opposed to sites along a linear line? So it's like a Daragor like map. The answer is yes, and there's a reason we don't. This is the noodle incident map. This map is a walking noodle incident.
I don't know why people keep insist on going through the tunnels, because we can just dig around the mountains.
Dig around the mountains. There's a spiraling.
We'll be digging around the mountains when we come.
Like, look, we have pickaxes, we have.
Ah, it's Tom Lowe.
Well, that's
a different one. Oh,
it's Tom Lowe. Important question is that Tom Lowe's YouTube show? Oh.
Who doesn't love Tom Lowe YouTube show? Oh no! Oh, I nearly went off the mountain.
There is a lot of lag.
There's always a lot of lag at this point.
I don't think that's. I think that's 400 people on the server with 300 shots.
Why can't I see anything? Where are my particles?
Everybody loves Doom!
Oh my god, that was a good creep, that was a good gobo explosion.
Stupid snapshot, I
now,
see
Krungor on this map is going
brutal.
To be fantastic. Come on, show me some Krungor. Show me
well,
the Krungor.
The thing is though, there, you have those deathworm chains over there, and you have the mountain, so you can just lay on the mountain.
Well, you say that as if you have total control over where you can go.
This is cruel.
And plus, a lot of people have safe fall for some reason. Oh, yeah.
This could also be surprisingly deadly.
Nah. Nobody ever dies to goblins, though. Nobody.
They do. A lot of people do.
I don't see, like, triple kills of goblins. With these goblins, at least.
Oh, I'm dead.
What?
Oh no, I have safe fall, I forgot.
Yeah, like, come on, that was me.
Sorry, I'll need to get that block.
Hey. I would have been totally dead if I didn't have safe fall. And many people don't have safe fall. I have safe fall because that's a Krungor killing kit.
Sorry, Alda. Hug.
No! Oh, wait, we can!
Flying.
Yay! Yeah, we've recently upgraded to 1.9, where hugging by just shifting into each other is now broken, because all you do is push each other away, like your magnets gently repelling.
Oh god, the
boss
spawn has a hole in it,
blocking.
Because they're idiots.
I mean, I guess you designed like a shield with a peace symbol on it. Then you need to have one with like a war symbol on it, when you don't, when you're being angry blocking.
Hey! Stop it! Oh my word.
This map is fantastic, though. Come on, don't tell me that this map doesn't get the best reactions out of the dwarves.
Okay, well, I flew down the mountain to the very bottom, and I took one heart.
I like the reaction where
that's
they say this map is horrible
weird.
Because the final shrine is silly.
I just
all the lights.
I just love the.
Any Jimmy's are these?
I think Skeleton may have come through. See, there's a guy here now destroying the proc hole.
It's because I started taking it to bits a bit.
See, this is. I thought this shrine was going to be the hardest one for the mobs in general, because you just get the least attack creeps on it.
Yeah, but it's too spammy, so.
Hmm?
It's pretty spammy, so.
Well, the entire game is.
Nah, that's true.
Yeah, this game is based around the idea of spamming a button. Or two.
Yeah. Hey, those dwarves are idiots to stay on the shrine while my goblin boxes blow up and they
Ow. Oh. I just teleported backwards.
Ooh, venom buttons.
Hey, can I heal? Thank you.
Are you a white mage?
What?
That's my skin color, not through that.
What?
I'm just saying, white mage gets the healing abilities.
But dark mage has the power to crush your skull.
Nobody screws with the white mage.
Wow. Such terrible stereotypes.
I'm not referring to skin color, I'm referring to robe color. That's very important. If one of your friends starts wearing black leather, starts mucking around incantations of death, and starts murmuring things about the skulls of Kalush and just four more emeralds until I have that zombie army, you need to start, talking to them about their life choices.
Nah.
So you just described the average metalhead?
Yes.
No, metalheads generally tend to be quite polite. Look at Mill.
Well, you never said anything about being impolite in those words.
Yeah, but if your friend starts wearing tons of black leather and starts summoning zombies,
you can be a demonic necromancer and be perfectly polite. I don't see why one would exclude the other.
Don't let your friends become necromancers, dude.
I'm in the Hergesnerv arc. Yay.
Oh man, I'm glad the screen finally went away.
That was very funny though. It did literally sound like you'd taken a sheet of tin foil and were just crumpling it gently against the mic.
Maybe that's an illusion. She wanted us to think that there was rain.
Hey! Stop petting me, kill that guy.
Go away, don't. I'm murdering for my own fun. I'm gonna go through this shrine is not long for this world. And then the real fun begins.
Gold left. You'll be fine. You'll be fine for another 3 minutes.
Yo, lime
stone. Gotta say, this place is really benefiting from Tom's suggestion about the effect that goblin explosions should have on the ground.
Yeah.
And all the grass is now podzol. Every inch of grass is now podzol. Well, not every inch, I can still see tons of it. But still, many inches are now podzol. I have just taken in this game of playing with the warrior class of just firing my bow randomly into the distance.
Like what I'm doing right now is just placing my goblin boom boxes on Nist where we're supposed to spawn so we don't fall.
Quarry.
What?
Nist was defending the quarry. Oh dear, what an idiot.
Oh, it's my...
Did anybody establish a hospital or something?
Yeah, well I've been back here.
Oh, you can fire
skull. If Rob did it, that would be a trend, but... the one good thing
me.
That he does doesn't become a trend.
Yeah, because it's so absurd. The things that he does are absurdly weird. And I love it. Yeah.
What about highways?
Highways, spawn camping, sky basing, everything's fine. Healing people? Nah, we don't do that.
Boring.
Well, actually, somebody is healing me. Thank you.
You guys better have just slab the heck out of that final shrine.
Who's this guy? He's not well.
Having seen what final shrine currently looks like, it's not pretty.
I'm just doing my...
I did my best!
Sometimes, Alda, even you cannot see the situation.
Okay, I am now doing a runner.
I'm running to front.
I'm running to final. I'm so tempted to just block out final on the way up, but I'm not.
Fall aback. Oh, there's goom boxes.
Goomba boxes.
Oh yeah.
Oh wow, final has been fortified alarmingly.
Yeah.
It's as if people knew it was coming.
Haha! Oh, I'm Ogre Mage! Okay.
I like how everyone is repairing armor with the stars. After
not everybody.
Video.
Oh, hey. Slabbed off. Somebody slabbed off.
Ugh. Bye. Okay, they're through. Did somebody slab off the tunnel?
Yeah, but it's unslabbed. Oh, that's a doom! Oh, I didn't realize it's a doom.
Yeah, it's doom. Cross of doom, man.
I just ran out into the tunnel with 100 mana.
Yeah, you better be careful.
I on the other hand, played the smart and fled.
Yeah.
Hey, Ogre Mage, welcome.
I fled before it was even seen as Curse of Doom.
I realize that because I'm almost always Ogre Mage in this map for some reason.
See, this now looks hilarious. This is going to be great. I'm sitting in the roof of the temple with my bow.
I see you. You're just waiting to shoot them as they come in.
Just knowing what's about to happen. Mm-hmm. Oh, these dwarves on the edge, like a terrible time. Oh, the cloud is just coming across to block the view to us.
Ready? Here they come.
And now.
And here comes the boom.
Here comes the boom.
I wanna be here.
Can these guys blow this up already? I have no restrictions to shrine protection now, so I can just go all the way around.
Oh, this place is not gonna last.
No, but it's gonna be slightly less awful than the last time because
people
we
have
something to defend.
Oh, I hate the fact that people have learned about this map. Like, my amusement was total every single time people went, wait, where are they coming from?
Yeah. The second test game. There's still people down there, by the way.
You're not gonna make Jimmy's.
Wow, that was a bad typo.
What did you say?
Don't look at. Just look at what that one Lance put in chat.
Don't back off.
Yep, Alda. Yeah. Look how long your fancy defenses lasted.
Yeah, well, not as long as they would have done if it's not had out the action.
Yeah.
If Alder was there to hold them.
This is great. This is how I imagined this final shrine would happen, except with probably less blocks around, if I'm honest. Now there's suddenly AIs everywhere.
Yeah.
They've really upped the volume of AIs decently, I think.
Hello guys, I'm here to set you on fire.
Oh,
nope, GG's bomb.
Oh, GG's bomb.
Why is he not horning? There we go.
There you go.
Some of that would be nice. Did we lose fall when I wasn't paying attention?
Yeah, it's fall.
Sadly, we did.
I was too greedy with my procs.
Yeah, bad boy.
Now Lance is gonna die. Well, now he fell back briefly.
Oh, Teb?
Yeah?
Would you like to be on fire?
I'm already on fire, we. I'm substantially aflame. There's nothing but fire and explosion. I can't see a flipping thing except for the fire and the explosions. This map was not designed with Doom or Gobos or Ogres in existence.
In fact, all about my minions.
I mean, this map was designed to kill people at the final shrine.
Oh,
Bolt need to hit immediately by Jobo and Kaboom.
Ah! I did pot lag.
I hope guys don't kill my bats, because my bats are annoying.
The walls and swappies. How do I get...
How do I get to that train? Where's Roman?
Roman, are you high?
Hello.
Pardon me while I cover every surface for a second.
There's Jimmy running down the mountain.
Come on, Bruce, look more horn, please.
Oh, I'm dead.
No, come on, guys.
Oh, I think this guy's glitched out.
Bye, Roman.
Apparently.
Well, I miss will do
giving
that.
Giving up then, yes. Oh! Drat it!
This is happening pretty much, isn't it? Oh, that's the golem.
Oh, dear.
Oh, Bruce is here.
I'm going out front to die like a man.
Oh, I'm not going to do that. Oh, goodness. Not really wild about any of these. Good. Wow, you... bye.
That was a fun way to die. I positioned myself on the edge of the mountain and left them. Wait, Paul, are you a golem?
What? Why do I have an orb of rebirth? That made no sense.
Are you alive, Alda?
No, I
she died.
Died like 5 seconds before you did. Think we take, whatchamacallit, this knight, the rebirth star, but oh, I missed hearts of absorption when you're getting swarmed in vinyl.
What happened to all the people? There's 10 left. Oh no, the shrine is the other guy.
I assume none of them are vinyl.
I used my ogre magic life to distract Roman and push him down the mountain.
Okay.
I'm just gonna sit here on vinyl. Hope nobody notices me.
Oh yeah.
Oh. Roman finally made it.
Where are all the dwarves?
I don't know!
Where the heck? This map,
they're all
lol.
The staircase!
This map, lol. Are they still waiting at the bottom?
No, they're trying to regen me.
I love this map.
Dwarves.
It just makes a good map.